الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ولا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome again to the inevitable journey. We continue unfolding the scenes and the events of the day of reckoning, the day of gathering, the day of resurrection. A heavy day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described it to be. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will speak to each one of us. As the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, in hadith Adi ibn Abi Hatim radiyallahu an, and the hadith in the two sahih, ma minkum min ahadin illa sayukallimuhu rabbuhu laysa baynahu wa baynahu turjuman. There is none of you but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will speak to, without a translator, without anybody in between. Brothers and sisters in Islam, fawa rabbika lanas'alannahum ajma'in amma kanu ya'malun. By your Lord, O Muhammad, we will ask all of them about every little thing that they used to do. Brothers and sisters in Islam, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلُ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. Whoever will good deed, even if it is the weight of an atom, he will see. And whoever works a work of evil, even if it is the weight of an atom, he will see. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the last episode, we talked about the first and very that we all have to pay attention to. What is next? What would be the next question? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered this, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered this also in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in a surah that you all know, ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. Then you will be asked in the day of resurrection about the pleasures that you enjoyed in this world. في صحيح مسلم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, Abu Huraira narrates that one day Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله عنه came out of his house and he met with Abi Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنهما. And they asked one another, what got you out of the house? They said, each one of them said, hunger got us out of the house. By all the sudden, they saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam also coming out of the house. And they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about why he came out. And he said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ, by the one in whose hand my soul is, الَّذِي أَخْرَجَنِي هُوَ الَّذِي أَخْرَجَكُمَا. The one thing that got me out of the house, out of my house, is the same thing that got you out of your houses. And he said, it is hunger. Can you imagine? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, Umar ibn al-Khattab, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hungry. They do not have food in their homes. And they went to a companion, Al-Haytham ibn Taymiyyah, radiallahu, basically offered them a meal, some dates and some meat. And after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abi Bakr al-Siddiq and Umar ibn al-Khattab ridwanillahi alayhim finished eating, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed them and he said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ, by the one in whose hand my soul is, أَخْرَجَكُمَا مِن بُيُوتِكُمُ الْجُوعِ, hunger got you out of your homes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided that meal for you. And you ate. وَاللَّهِ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَنْ هَذَا النَّعِيمِ. By Allah, you will be asked in the day of resurrection about that pleasure that you just enjoyed. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided for you, you will be asked about in the day of resurrection. Brothers and sisters in Islam, in more than one hadith, You will be asked about your health, even about the cold war. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith fi Sunan al-Tirmidhi, رضي الله عنه أصبح في سربه معافا في سربه عنده قوت يومه فكأنما حيزت له الدنيا. Whoever wakes up in the morning healthy, provision of one day, he is like someone who owns this world. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the ni'mah that you are enjoying, it will be a question in the day of resurrection. Now, how can you come out of that question? Like we mentioned, the salah, perfecting the salah, doing it sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember, the inevitable journey is a beginning point for you, is not the end. We are sharing the inevitable journey with you in order for you to start working, in order for you to handle the things that you have according to the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted you to handle. Now, what is going on with the ni'mah, with the pleasures, with the favors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon you? How can you come out of that question in the day of resurrection? The answer in the tongue of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the hadith in Sahih al-Imam Muslim, hadith Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَرْضَى لِلْعَبْدِ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ الْأَكْلَةَ فَيَحْمَدَهُ عَلَيْهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with his servant. Once he eat a meal, he says, Alhamdulillah. Before you eat, you say, Allahumma barik lana fima razaqna. After you eat, you say, Alhamdulillah alladhi at'amana wa saqana wa ja'alana muslimin. With this, you're showing gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa yashrabu sharbata fayahmadahu alayha. And you drink a drink of water and you say, Alhamdulillah for it. If you show gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the ni'mah, for the favor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon you, then you will come out of that difficult question that will be addressing every single favor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a lot of people think that this is easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran passed a ruling. He said, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشُّكُورِ. Very few of my servants are grateful to me. Brothers and sisters in Islam, very quickly, how to show gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the favors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon you in order to come out of that question in the day of resurrection. Number one, you must confess in your heart that whatever you have is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not because of your resources. Your resources are just means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided you to. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Whatever ni'mah, whatever favor that you have is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, after you confess this inwardly, in your heart, that this ni'mah is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you must also speak of it, not in a boastful manner, but in a humble manner. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. Speak of that ni'mah in order to direct the people to the source, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once you're asked about the things that you are enjoying in this world, tell the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon me. Then the people will know the source of the ni'mah, the source of the favors that you are enjoying in this world is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then they will be directed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, you should not use that ni'mah but in what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you should give the dues, the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ni'mah. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon you money, then you must pay the zakah in your money. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon you knowledge, then you must share that knowledge with the people. And brothers and sisters in Islam, you should not use that ni'mah but in what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, that is not it. Another question, very famous question in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The hadith fi Mustadrak al-Hakim, narrated by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, and Musnad al-Imam Ahmad, wa Sunan al-Tirmidhi, wa al-Nasai, and others. Hadith Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Hadith Abi Barzat al-Aslami radiyallahu anhum, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the feet of the son of Adam will not move in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before he gets asked about five things. An umrihi, about his age, about his life, how did he spend his life? Wa an jasadihi, about his body and his body parts, how did he consume this body? Wa an malihi, about his wealth, how did he earn it and in what did he spend it? Wa an ilmihi, and about his knowledge, did he act upon that knowledge himself or not? Brothers and sisters in Islam, those are very famous five questions that a believer, a Muslim, will be asked in the day of resurrection. Your life is your capital. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, نِعْمَتَانِ مَغْبُونٌ فِيهِمَا كَثِيرٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ الصَّحَّةُ وَالْفَرَاغُ. Hadith Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما في صحيح الإمام البخاري. There are two ni'mah, two favors that a lot of people are losers in regard to, or regarding to, is their health and their time. I'm amazed sometimes at some people who celebrate their birthdays. Amazing. They are celebrating, already losing 1 year of their capital. Or I'm amazed at someone who sits in front of the computer for hours doing nothing but just chatting or playing video games or whatever he's doing in the internet. And once you ask him, he tells you, I'm wasting some time. You are wasting your capital, brothers and sisters in Islam. And every single second, every single minute, you will be asked about it in the day of resurrection. Your life. عَنْ عُمْرِهِ فِيمَا أَفْنَاهُ. The question number two, وَعَنْ جَسَدِهِ فِيمَا أَبْلَاهُ. And about his body and his body parts, how did you consume this body? In the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or in the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Actually, the Quran told us about certain limbs that we will be asked about. إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادَ كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْؤُولًا. Indeed, your hearing, what do you do with your hearing? Do you hear the Quran with it? Do you hear good words with it? What about your vision? What about your heart? Let's take a short break and inshallah continue on with those five questions that we will be asked about in the day of resurrection. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
The scale of justice will be broke before man. Now you shall have to explain.